Hi, this is Srinivas Reddy. Now we are going to discuss about data science, right? So what we are going to learn in this data science means, let us observe the content, right? So in this data science that we are going to discuss about data analysis, machine learning, deep learning, artificial intelligence. So these are all the technologies that we are going to learn in this data science. For implementing, we are going to use the programming languages, Python programming, R programming, and data mining tool. So in this first session that we are going to discuss about, first we are going to start that what is the data science, who is the data scientist, and who can become a data scientist, right? What is the real-time process of a data science? What are the applications that we are having? What are the applications present we are using by using this data science? What are the technologies that we are going to use in this data science? And what is the prerequisite knowledge that we require to learn this data science course? Right? So let us observe that, okay, what is the data science and so here we are going to discuss the entire content, like how to do the analysis, how to do the visualization by using R programming and Python programming and one of the data mining tool, right? So how to use the statistics, that plays the main role here. We are going to, okay, learn these the statistical concepts, right? So let us observe.
Contact this number. Those who are okay attended in mobiles, right? Please select one of the option, that it is call via audio device, then you will get audio, right? Yes. Let us start this. What is a data science? What is data science? In this data science, what we are going to discuss means, what is data science, who is data scientist, and who can become a data scientist? What is the real-time process of a data science? Data science applications. What are the technologies that we are going to use in data science? What is the prerequisite knowledge that we require to learn this data science? Yes. First of all, let us observe that what is a data science. First, let us observe that what is data science. See, data science is not simple like a database just for manipulating the data or managing the data. So it is a interdisciplinary field where we are going to use in the statistics, analysis, machine learning, artificial intelligence, neural networks, all this. Yes, simply that what I am saying here means data science is a concept of statistics, machine learning, data analysis, and related methods for understand, for what purpose means, to understand and analyze with the data. Yes, this is the common definition that we are having, whatever the textbook it is, whatever the browser it is, wherever you search, you'll get this definition. Data science is a concept of statistics, data analysis, machine learning. For what purpose? For understanding and analyzing the data. Okay, here, and related methods. What is this related methods means? Not only the statistics and machine learning and analysis, here we are going to use some related methods in this data science, like we are going to do some of the processings, we are going to use some of the algorithms, we are going to use some of the statistical methods, okay, scientific methods. All these comes under these data science. Is it clear that what is a data science? Right. Now let us observe the importance of the data science. What is the importance of the data science? So frequently we are going to observe in the newspapers, in so many articles, right? Through internet also we are observing so many articles about these data science. We are having so much of demand in the market. So these are all the different articles that what we observe in the previous news. See, how do you make a data scientist? Right? International technology lo viplavam data science. Yes, we are having so much of demand. So, okay, data science, machine learning lo 50,000 jobs. Right? So these are all the different, okay, these are all the different news that we are observing daily. Once observe this, data scientists now earn more than CS. Whenever if you observe the software engineers, okay, whenever if you compare with any other jobs, software engineers are getting high packages. But whenever if you compare with the chartered accountants, CS, they are having the high packages than the software engineers. But now how it is means, data scientists are getting, data scientists are earning more than the CS. Right. See, if you have a 10 plus, okay, sorry, 5 plus years of experience, then you can make 75 lakhs of package. Overall average, okay, of the average salaries, it is, okay, whenever if you observe here, okay, 8 lakhs is the average salary in India. This is not a data that what I prepared, okay. So one of the Times lead it is, okay, team leads survey it is in India. So we are having so many openings in the next upcoming 2 lakhs analytics are required next 3 years in only in India. I'm talking about only in India, right? So this much of demand that we are having, okay, once observe the peak demand of data scientists. So it is not only for the experienced people or not only for the, okay, freshers. We are having demand for all the freshers, 0 to 1 years of experience, 4 to 8, 8 to 16, based on, okay, your knowledge that we are having the, okay, demand. It is not like only for the experienced people or not only for the freshers, not like that. But having so many positions in this as a data analyst, as a machine learning developer, as a data engineer, as a data scientist, okay, we are having so many roles based on our experience, right? So these are all the different, okay, once observe this, by observing this peak, what you can understand? This is job competition in the data science, right? It is not like, okay, Java, .NET or any other tools like a reporting or ETL tools like that, or like a testings, okay? So nowadays, it is very hard to find the data scientist. It is very hard to find the data scientist. Not only find the data scientist, okay, it is very find the people who is data scientist. Who is the data scientist? All right. So that much of demand that we are having less competition, okay, in the present market. We are having so much of shortage, okay, of these data scientists. All right. So who can become a data scientist? Who is a data scientist and who can become a data scientist? Once observe this here, what are the, okay, skills that we require to become a data scientist? First thing, it is a statistics. See, already in the, okay, definition of the data science that we discussed there, if you want to be, okay, what is the data science? Data science is the first concept of the statistics. Statistics plays the main role here, okay. Without the statistics, there is no data science. Without statistics, there is no data science. Whatever the methods and algorithms that we are using here, all these methods, algorithms, concepts, everything that it is going to, it depends on the statistics only, right? So here, what are the skills that we require means, coming to the statistical knowledge, in this statistical knowledge that we have, okay, we require the mathematical concepts, probability concepts, and statistical skills. These are all the skills that we require. And also coming to the computer skills, okay, here we require the, okay, software engineer skills, like some of the programming, some of the subjects, some of the tools that we require here. And also we require the domain knowledge also, okay. So overall, all these skills that we require. First it is, okay, statistics is very important. See, if a person who is having statistical background or statistical academic, right, so they can become a statistician. they can become a statistician. Statistician means normally they are going to use Excel sheets or some of the statistical tools to do the statistics, right? See, if you have a knowledge on the statistics, if you are okay, only statistical knowledge means it is not possible to become a data scientist. Plus this that we require the computer skills. Then what is about this domain means already you are having an experience, or otherwise you are okay manipulating your resume with the 3 years or 4 years or experience. At that time we require the domain knowledge. But as a fresher or as a 1 year of experience, that we don't require any domain knowledge. Here the main two skills that we require, that it is data science and that is statistics and computer skills. So let us observe that what I am saying means a person who is better at a statistics, than any other software engineer, or a person who is better as at software engineering than any other statistician, can become a data scientist. Is it clear that what I am saying? A person who is better at statistics than any other software engineer, or a person who is better at software engineering than any other statistician, is a data scientist or can become a data scientist. Yes. So these are all the skills that we require here, but no need to worry about these statistics always. Statistics means not in advanced level, right? So whatever the subject that we are having in 9th and 10th standard, that it is enough for us. Like what is mean, median, variance, standard deviation, all this. Even though in our course curriculum, we are going to start from basic, that it is from ground level onwards that we are going to start. Yes, no need to worry about these statistics here. Everything that we are going to discuss in our course, right? So these are all the skills that we require that to become a data science. Right? Now let us observe. Anadi, you have a problem in audio. If anyone is having a problem with audio, yes, please answer through the chat box. Anadi is having a problem with audio. Are you getting any disturbance? So if you connected through mobile, please select call via audio device. In laptops or systems, not required. Yes, right. Thank you. Yes. Now let us observe here. Modern data scientist. Say just now that we observe that data science, data scientist is very hard. Finding a data scientist is very hard, and also finding a people who understand who a data scientist is also very hard. All right. So data science is the sexiest job of the 21st century. So just know that whatever that we observe, mathematics and statistics is required for us. Next, some of the computer skills, that it is programming and database that we require for graphical representations, that we here we required some storytelling skills. Graphical representation is nothing but storytelling skills, the visualization part. Yes. And also we require some domain knowledge. That domain knowledge is only for the experienced people, not required for the freshers and 1 or 2 years of experience. So this is about modern data scientists. Now let us observe what is the real-time data science course. Once if you understand this real-time data science process, then you will get clear idea about how, what is the data science, how the work is going, going on the data science process, how we are going to collect the data, what we have to do, and finally what we have to deploy. Yes. So once observe this data science process, first we have to collect the data from the real world. So it depends on your clients, whoever your clients, there we are going to collect our data, right? So at the time of collecting the data, here the data is in different formats. Some of the data that we are going to observe, structured data. Some of the data that we are going to observe, the unstructured data. Some of the data that we are going to observe, the semi-structured data. We are going to observe structured data, unstructured data, and semi-structured data. What is structured data? The data which is organized well, that it is called structured data. the data which is not organized well. See, whatever the data that you are going to observe in our Excel sheets or in the databases, there we can find the structured data. But some of the situations that we can observe unstructured data also. The combination of structured and unstructured is called a semi-structured data. See, as a data scientist, here we have to ready to work on any type of data. It is not like a case that, we are going to work, I am going to work only on the structured data. I am not responsible for the unstructured data. It is not possible. So, whatever the data it is, you are ready to work on that. Yes, once the data is completed, and then you have to start the process. What type of process that we have to do means, let us observe here, let us take DMART is our client. DMART is our client. So DMART is having so many locations, that is so many branches it is having. Whenever if I want to start the analysis on there, then we have to collect the data. So from the different locations, that is from the different branches, first we have to extract the data. That it is called data extraction. After extracting the data, so whenever if I start the analysis on the data, if I find any different formats, for example, one of the product purchase date that I find like date, month, year format, in one of the branch that I observe that the date format is year, month, date. So with having two different formats here, it is not possible to do the analysis. So what we have to do means we have to make this data into a common format. We have to make this data into a common format and then we have to start the analysis on the data. So this is called a data extraction. This is called data extraction. And not only this, in coming to this data processing, we have to do normalize the data like this. We are having some of the steps, but whenever if we entered into the project, then very clearly we are going to understand this with the practicals. Yes, next coming to the cleaning data, after processed, then we have to start the cleaning. What type of data that we have to clean here means, here we have to clean the missing data. If you find any missing data here, that type of data you have to clean, right? So if you find any inconsistency data, then you have to clean that. If you find any noisy data, this type of data that we have to clean, I will show you with practicals that what type of data that we can consider as a missing, inconsistency and noise. Right? With one of the data set that I will show you what type of data that we can consider all this. Once the data is clean, as a data scientist, first we have to understand the data here and then we have to start the analysis. See, at the time of understanding the data, if you are not going to satisfied with the data, otherwise, at the time of doing analysis on the data, if the data is not going to support to do the analysis, again, we are going to send the data to the process, cleaning, all right? So, up to the satisfaction, we are going to recycle this. Next, once the analysis is completed, next, what we are going to do means, we are going to do some, predictions on this data. We are developing some of the predictive models by using some of the models and algorithms. Right, it is the part of machine learning. It is the part of machine learning that it is for future predictions. Now, analysis is completed, future predictions, predictive models is also completed. What is the next step means? Whatever the analysis predictions that you've done, that we have to deploy your clients or your higher authorities. Whatever the code that you written, whatever the algorithms and methods that you written, your clients and higher authorities are not going to understand this. Whatever that you return, they are not going to understand that we are going to convert into the graphical representation, that it is visualization in the form of reporting we are going to submit. Once if you submit these graphical representations, that it is reportings, then they are going to make a decisions based on that analysis that what you've done, based on that reporting, they are going to take a decisions that how to improve their business. Yes, so after visualization and then whatever the product that we develop, again that we are going to deploy in the real world. Again this product, again it is going to produce the data. Again we have to collect the data. Again we have to start the process, analysis, all this. This data science is a never end process. It is a cyclic process. It is a cyclic process. So whatever that we observe here, everything that we are going to implement in our project, just it is not as not just for learning the concept, whatever the concept that we learn, that we are going to implement in our projects. Yes, so this is the data science. And next let us observe here some more topics, like what are the different applications that we are having. Different applications, I'm not going to discuss any new applications here. Whatever the applications that we are using in our daily life, only those applications that we are observing here. See what it is? Gmail. So in this Gmail, we are having inbox folder and spam folder. Inbox, similarly spam. Here what will happen means, whatever the message, whatever the mail that you receive, that it is going to move to the inbox or spam. Inbox means what? Whatever the message that it is useful to you, that it will move to the inbox. Whatever the message that it is not useful to you, that it is going to move to the spam. Right. Who is going to decide all this? At the time of sending, sender is mentioning that this is not important, this is important. After receiving, you are taking a decision that it is important, let us go to inbox, not important, let us go to spam. Right, the system is going to take a decision. Right, the system is going to learn your message before whatever that you observe. Meer open cheyakamunde system anedi tanukunte munne nechukoni it is going to take a decision that whether this message is useful to the whether it is useful to the user or not. This is the one of the project that it is comes under data science in our course. This is also one of the part. This project is also one of the part. Next let us observe here, Redbus, Redbus, of one more app it is Paytm. If you want to if you want to go to your hometown present Dasara holidays, now the cost, it is high or medium? High, very high. Yes, but if you want to travel in weekdays, normal days, normal prices. Again, if you want to travel in weekends, again prices increase. Who is going to decide that? Any bus operator is doing all the manipulations, any updates, right? Or a software engineers, the developers are doing all this? No, the machine, the system itself, it is going to take a decision. What is the price? What is the price? Let us observe this Ola bill. If I want to travel from here to Hitech City, now we'll get one price, total price, total fare. Again after 5 minutes, again if I check, the price will be changed dynamically or not? It will change. Who is going to take decisions there? See, if it is traffic, having traffic, at that time it is one price. Having lot of cabs availability, having demand, if it is raining, so automatically the system is going to understand and it is going to learn what it is happening, and it is going to work based on that. So these are all the different projects that what we are having. See, whenever if you observe in our Google search engines or in Gmail, whenever if you try to type something, automatically the next word it is going to predict that what you are typing. If I am typing hi, hello, automatically it will suggest that how are you, so and so, like this. It is like we'll get some doubt that someone is mimicking our mind, someone is reading our mind. So that type of doubts we will get it, that everything it is going to this type of project that it is going to depends on the data science. Yes. So this is spam, stock price prediction, one of the interesting domain where they are going to use this data science. Facial recognitions, voice to text, autonomous cars, self-driving cars, autonomous cars. Amazon Go, how many of you know this? This is one of the advanced shopping technology. Once go to the YouTube and then type Amazon Go, so they use advanced shopping technologies like machine learning, deep learning, okay, fusion sensors like this, there what will happen means no need to, there is no securities, there is no helpers, there is no supporters, there is no cashiers. Just you have to scan it and then you have to enter into that shopping mall and then you have to take that whatever that you require and then you have to simply exit from the shopping mall. Just go to YouTube and then type Amazon Go, right? So already I'm having that video also. So simply what you have to do means just you have to enter, just scan it and then you have to enter. And then you have to enter. Okay, there is no security guards, nothing is there. Whatever that you required, okay, let us take it, it will be added in your chart. Otherwise, it will be minus in your chart. So if you again, if you want to take it, okay, it will be added in your chart, right? So like that, here they used so much of technologies like a deep learning, computer vision, okay, machine learning algorithms, all this, right? So what will happen with this type of technologies means the people who is not having a technical knowledge, right? Security guards, they are missing their jobs. They are losing or not? Cashiers, they are losing or not? Even they are having a computer skills, how to operate the computer also, but not required. Not required for us, all right? So we are having so much of demand because of that we are going to involve in this type of projects. That's why only as a data scientist, as a machine learning developer, as a artificial intelligence engineer, we are having demand means for the purpose of this, right? So this is one of the application. Next, let us observe that what are the different technologies that we are going to use. So already that we discussed that data science is one of the main, okay, part of this. Statistics is one of the main part of this data science. Without statistics here, okay, it is not possible to work with the data science. Why? Because whatever that we are going to work, everything it is going to, okay, depends on the statistics. Right? Next, machine learning, Python programming, R programming. So for this Python programming and R programming, we are having the integrated development environments, IDEs. However, that we are having NetBeans Eclipse for Java. Okay, MySQL Workbench for MySQL. Similarly, here also we are having IDEs, R Studio IDE for the R, Anaconda. It is one of the data science distributor, data science framework. Whatever the programming languages, whatever the tools that we required, whatever the packages that we required, everything that it is available in the Anaconda. No need to install separately Python, R, okay, IDEs separately. Once if you install Anaconda, everything is available in your system. Next, numerical Python. Pandas, where we are going to work on the structures, scientific Python, machine learning, scientific kit learn, natural language processing, toolkit, OpenCV, matplotlib, graphical representations, advanced graphical representations, seaborn, deep learning concept, artificial intelligence concepts, right? Here TensorFlow, Keras, Theano, these are all the different packages belongs to the deep learning. So these are all the skills that we require here. So that's why only we are going to take nearly 3 months of course duration. Here it is not possible to learn it with just within 30 days or 45 days. Yes? So these are all the technologies. And what is the pre-requesting knowledge that we require here? What is the pre-requesting knowledge that to learn this data set? Right? Is there anything under that heading? Is there any points in that heading? Nothing. So what I am saying simply, not required any skills, not required any pre-requesting knowledge to learn this data science. Why? Because coming to the statistics, that statistics already you know, everyone will know about this statistics where we learn in the 9th and 10th standard. No need to take a separate courses on the data science once again. Yes, anyhow in our course that we are going to start from the basic level onwards, that it is what is the mean, what is the median, okay, from what is the minimum and maximum, there onwards we are going to start about these statistics. Next, coming to the computer skills here, if you are perfect in Java or if you are perfect in C or C++, these technologies that we are not going to use. We are going to use Python programming and we are going to use R programming. So these two are the programming languages anyone should learn from the starting onwards. From the starting onwards, everyone should be. Already if you know Python and R means it is good. It is good. Already you came from the statistical background, academic means it is good. But what I am saying is, what is the prerequisite? So statistic that we are going to learn here, Python and R programming language, everyone should learn as a fresher. Right? So these type of languages are not okay available last 5 to 10 years. Everyone is learning now itself. Right? So that's what is what I am saying means the prerequisiting knowledge means okay, that no need to worry about that. Everyone are eligible. If you have a degree qualification, then you are eligible to learn this. Not belongs to any branch or not belongs to any department or not belongs to any degree. All are eligible for this. Yes. So this is about data science. Now we are going to discuss about the machine learning. Very interesting concept. How the machines are going to work? What is the difference between the human learning and machine learning? As a humans, how we are going to learn? As a machine, how it is going to learn? Right? As a humans, what type of help that we are going to take for learning? What type of support that we are going to take? Same machines, how it is going to take the support? So these type of with some example, practical example that I am going to explain you that what is this machine learning. So my sincere request it is, let us continue the session immediately. So whenever it is terminated, whenever it is disconnected, so once again join with the same link. Once again join with the same link. Here we are having a problem that it is limit is up to 40 minutes only. So we are going to continue our session. So one more 40 minutes that we are going to continue our session. So if it is disconnected from your side, please connect once again with the same link. Whatever the link that you are having, so with the same link, okay, once again connect it. Why? Because now we are going to discuss about one of the interesting concept that how, what is the machine learning with the practical example that I am going to show you, how the machines are going to learn similar like a human learning, right? So what is